What's going on? It's Keke, aka Shy Face Diva. Thank you for joining me in the kitchen again. Today is a special Valentine's Day edition. We're going to be making a heart-shaped cake. And if you're like me, I don't have all the different type of shape cake pans, you know, the heart, star. You know, I only have like the bump pan, the circle one, and the square one, okay? So we're going to use what we got to create this really easy heart-shaped cake. Okay, so you're only going to need one box of your favorite type of cake. I was going to do red velvet, but switched up a little bit. So I'm going to be using Betty Crocker strawberry cake. Just one box. You can use two boxes if you want the cake to be thicker. Okay, you're going to use just one square baking pan. You see, I use it a lot. And this one is an 8x8 one. And then you're going to use one 8x8 circle pan, or you can use a 9x9, whichever one you have on hand. Okay guys, so let's jump right into it. Okay guys, I didn't record the mixing process because I do not follow the directions on the box. The mix it comes with, that just gives me a base. I like to add stuff to my mix to give it more of a homemade, fluffier taste. Okay, so after you finish mixing your cake mix, you're going to divide it in the square one and a circle pan, okay? So we're going to half it up. I'm going to put half in the square one and then half in the circle one. Oh yeah, another thing, before you add your mix in there, I always grease mine with oil, butter, and flour. Put them in the baking pans. You're going to put these in the oven. I got my oven on 350. That might take 25 to 30 minutes to cook since it's separated and it's not much mix in each one. So I'm going to place these in the oven. Okay guys, it's been a little over 35 minutes. Okay, what you always want to do is check it first. Make sure your toothpick or your knife come out clean. So I'm sticking right in the middle. Raise it up. As you can see, the knife is clean. I mean, the cake is done. So I'm going to do the other one. And the knife is clean. Okay, so we're going to let these completely cool before we move to the next step. The next step is I transfer my square cake to the pan I'm going to be displaying it in. Okay, I couldn't use a regular cake plate because the heart-shaped cake tend to be bigger than a regular size cake. Okay, so once you place it, well, this one is a 17x12 foil pan I picked up in my local grocery store. Okay, once you put it in the pan that you're going to be having it in, you want to shape it in a diamond shape. As you can see, it's a diamond shape. Okay, that's how you're going to place the square one. The next thing, you want to take your round cake and put it on a separate sheet because you're going to be cutting this one. You want to cut it right down a half. Okay, this is going to be the top of your heart. It should be soft enough where you can cut it with a butter knife. Okay, so we're going to cut this right down the middle. Cut it right down the middle. It doesn't have to be even, but you do want to just cut it right down. Okay? So that's half and half. The next thing you want to do is take one half of your cake, and you want to place it the top of the diamonds on one side like that. You can line your corners up like on this side if you want, but you want to line them up. Be careful because the cake is going to be really soft. Okay. Then you want to take the other half and place it right on the side. And you can see the heart shape is starting to form. You see that? But once you put your icing and everything over it, it's going to look really pretty. So it's really easy, guys. All you did was bake two cakes, a square one and a circle one. Then you want to take your circle cake and cut it right down the middle. And you just want to place it on top of the diamond shaped square cake to form your heart. Okay, so now it's time to icing it. Okay guys, for my icing, I'm going to be using Betty Crocker's Rich and Creamy Vanilla Frosting. And my little special secret I do, I add Cool Whip with my icing to make it more fluffy. Okay guys, after you're done icing it, you know, this is what mine's look like. I'm not a pro or nothing. And you can decorate it, you know, do different color icings or whatever you want to do. But I hope you enjoy this, and I hope you guys have a great Valentine's, and I will see you guys next time.